Good afternoon on this Friday, July 20th. You know, we did want some rain across western Pennsylvania. As you can see, we are in low to moderate drought conditions, but we don't need it to all come at once. But that's how the drought-busting rains seem to come more often than not, and sure enough, that has happened today. And as a result, the National Weather Service has had to issue a flood watch for much of southwest PA. And as you can see, there's a flood warning in effect for the southern end of Pittsburgh. Fortunately, we do have a lot of pictures and viewer comments from social media sources, and this is a picture sent in from Pittsburgh by Kara Lutterman, and this is strongly advised for people not to do. As you can see, people are still trying to get through these flooded roadways, and this is a good way to ruin your new vehicle, if not put your own self in danger, so this is strongly not advised. The latest radar animation is encouraging for Pittsburgh as the line of showers and thunderstorms are slowly progressing off toward the south and east. So as we go later on into the afternoon and evening hours, the flooding threat should be removed from Pittsburgh. But we can't rule out additional flooding out across West Virginia as this line continues to sag toward the south. The main culprit behind the flooding situation is this very slow-moving to nearly stalled-out cold front that has been situated over much of southern Ohio and western Pennsylvania. And what you're currently looking at is just a loop of some of the surface observations since this morning. And as you can see, that front has barely moved over the past 12 hours. Switching over to some of the more recent surface observations, now we can see that to the south of the front, we're still dealing with some light southerly winds, and the dew points are still in the upper 60s to low 70s with the relative humidity near 100%. But behind the front, we've got more stable air moving in with those northerly winds. The dew points and the temperatures are now into the low 60s out across Erie and Akron and Cleveland, Ohio. And as we can see on visible satellite imagery, over time things will begin to clear out. And Michigan's actually enjoying a pretty nice day with hardly any cloud cover. And this is a more regional look at the water vapor, and this will tell you the real picture. We've got this trough diving into the Ohio Valley, and this is the reason why we're dealing with this front in the first place. But the front is having a hard time continuing to move toward the southeast because this trough is bumping into the subtropical Atlantic Ridge that is anchored across the eastern United States and the eastern seaboard. So over the next 12 hours, the flooding threat for Pittsburgh will be winding down, but over the next 2 to 3 days, the flooding concerns will shift a little bit more into eastern Virginia and northern North Carolina. And what you're looking at now is the 3-day forecast total rainfall from the Hydrometeorological Prediction Center. And they are forecasting between 3 to 4 inches across the mid-Atlantic. So this is something for interest there to probably take note of. So stay safe out there across Pennsylvania this afternoon. And that's all we have from us here at 28storms.com. If you would like to follow us, we are available on Facebook and Twitter. And you can simply just go to 28storms.com to find both of these methods. So thank you again and have a good afternoon.